Look at this.
Need a car? Date our son this summer and bring him out of his shell before college.
In exchange, we'll give you a Buick Regal.
Date is in quotes.
Congratulations on this. It is just so much fun. Jennifer, I have to start with you. I know you've done chemistry reads before. Mm-hmm. The chemistry required here is so different. It's got to be awkward. It's got to be off-putting. When did you know that Andrew was that person? He was Percy.
Honestly, Andrew and it was unexpected. I thought it was going to be kind of annoying to work with, like a 20-year-old all day. I was like, oh God, he's going to want to, talk about acting technique. I didn't know. I don't know 20-year-olds. Within the first 20 minutes, I would say, of being on set, we became extremely good friends.
Yeah, immediately.
Aww. Good friends. And so I feel like the chemistry was kind of the same, and he made me so much better at my job. He was so incredible.
We've just been so worried about our son.
He's going to Princeton in the fall.
No, I've heard of it.
We auditioned a lot of great actors, and it was the kind of thing, if we didn't find the right Percy, there was going to be no making the movie. It just wouldn't have worked. And as soon as he walked out of the audition, we just knew that that was Percy. He also put going to Harvard on hold to film this movie. So, there.
Harvard, I've heard of it. So, Andrew, in all seriousness, did you ask her about acting techniques?
I think it was less about acting techniques and more about how to be a person on a set and be kind and thoughtful of everybody's time. And she was such an amazing role model for that from the beginning. And
Is your role model?
No.
He's a little too young to be his role model.
I also think that I think it would have done such a disservice to the tone of this movie and this relationship if we were really in our separate corners and trying to get deeply into character.
No, we were together all the time. I'm going to teach you how to have fun.
I know Maddie, the character, you're here to teach Percy how to have fun. Not that Jennifer Lawrence needs any help in that department, but Andrew, if you were going to spend a day teaching Jennifer about having fun, what does that fun day for you include?
We go to Disneyland. No question. In fact, I can't really think about anything else or talk to her about anything else.
We are going to Disneyland.
Yeah, that's something that we've decided officially that we're going
to do. It's not a bucket list. It's a near future.
Yeah, yeah.
I have to ask about the song. I don't want to give it away, but there is a well-known Hall & Oates song that is pivotal in this. And one of the reasons that song kind of represents Jen's character as well. So I want each of you to pick a song that best represents the person you're sitting next to.
Whoa. Well, it's the Sheryl Crow song that you sent me. I don't remember the lyrical content of it.
But which Sheryl Crow song?
It's the one that's always in your head.
If it makes you happy.
Yeah, yeah. I don't think that.
I don't know how I feel about that.
No, I don't think that it represents you lyrically, but it's the song I now associate with you, I think. Because I love that song.
And for Andrew, Katie Tunstall, Suddenly I See.
Why that one?
come on. Suddenly I See. I can't do that.
That's me. I'm just,
I can't get that on key.
It has the energy
right
of
now, because I had milk in my coffee earlier. But
oh, that's why. That's why.
I know you were looking for someone early to mid-20s. I'm slightly older.
The age jokes in here, because I look at you, Jen, and first of all, I'm older than both of you by far. And I look at you, and you look so young to me.
Oh, God.
Have you ever felt old? Because to me, throughout this whole movie, despite the age bit, you never looked old or felt old to me.
I had to be in a two-shot with this youthful...
youngster.
Nubile, a gorgeous specimen. Yes, I did feel old, especially when I had to... when I reminded him that there was an internet before the YouTube, what was it? There was some YouTube he hadn't seen. I don't know.
Yeah.
There were many times where I would say something he didn't understand what I was saying, and I was like, I am ancient.
You have a Roadrunner tattoo on your entire back.
If she only did comedy, she would be one of the comedy greats. She just has so many tools in her toolbox. This is just one of them, but it was really one that hasn't been used on film. I mean, you could obviously, it's clear how funny she is when she does interviews, but I just feel like now everyone gets to see how funny she can be in a movie. That's really exciting.
Something for me?
Why?
Much like horror, I think comedy is a genre that needs to be seen in a theater with a group of people, because there is an something happens in that dark room, right? There's an energy. There's, you know, if you're sometimes, I can't tell you the difference between when I'm at home watching something alone and I'm watching a theater. It's just, it's, there's a different reaction. And I much prefer watching it in a theater. I laugh more. I enjoy it more. It's fun to laugh with other, as a group, with strangers in a dark room. I mean, that's the way it was made. It was made to be seen in a theater.
Get away from her! Oh, Maddie!
Look, we should go.